Canva Docs is here to blow your mind with visually supercharged documents. And Magic Write can do what? Use AI to write all these things from social posts to rom-com scripts. Well, let's see if this is the perfect match. We're diving in. Hey there, I'm Donna Moritz, founder of Socially Sorted, a Canva verified expert and Canva creator ambassador, and I help you grow your business with visual content. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell to get notified when I release new videos. First up, let's take a look at Canva Docs. So what is Canva Docs? Well, as you can see on this video here, it's a visual first document creator that goes well beyond boring word processing. You can design documents that are supercharged with videos, images, graphics, infographics, or charts and graphs, as you can see here, and everything's at your fingertips. So it's all in Canva, and it's also really easy to collaborate with team members. You can even embed presentations from Canva, as you can see here, directly into your doc. So no matter what other document tools you use, it's worth checking out. Let's take a closer look at how Canva Docs works. Just a heads up that at the time of this recording, Canva Docs was being rolled out firstly to a waitlist and Canva verified experts like myself. However, you can currently apply to have this feature added to your account at canva.com/docs. It's pretty quick, but allow up to 24 hours, and it will be coming soon to all accounts. Now, Canva Docs is free on all accounts, free, pro, teams, and education. However, bear in mind that there may be some additional features or content you get access to with paid subscriptions. Accessing Docs is easy from the homepage. You can start with a blank doc here, or you can come in here to the Docs section and you'll get a little bit more information and options on Docs, including a whole bunch of templates. Now, there are a couple of dozen templates at the moment, and rest assured, Canva will be designing more. As you can see, there are templates for all sorts of docs, from strategy and training docs to proposals and team documents, through to lesson plans for school, recipes, blogs, journals, trackers, and more. Let's click into this one. See in this Canva doc a lot of sections for this social media strategy template, so banners, photos, charts, and tables. You might also notice it's one long document without pages. This lack of pagination is somewhat deliberate from Canva, at least for now, as Canva docs are designed to be shared and collaborated with digitally or digital first, so rather than being exported to a fixed format and printed. Now, personally, I love how visually rich and responsive they are. I can access all my visual assets compared to, say, Google Docs, which I use, or Word Docs. But I've actually heard Canva Docs being likened more to something like Dropbox paper at the moment, which is almost more like a workspace than a printable doc. Now, you can print these docs in PDF format, but just bear in mind that the page breaks, unless you're spacing it evenly and putting a little bit of effort in for that, you'll probably find that it will cut off things in unusual spaces. So it's not designed to be printed perfectly, but you just need to come here to download and then choose A4, and it will print as a PDF, or you can choose A3 letter, however you like to print it. Let's take a look at a blank document now, and I just want to show you the magic shortcuts. Now, I can click my forward slash button on my keyboard to bring those up for Canva Docs, or you can press the plus button here. Now, you can see it's showing me a heading here. I'm going to just show you a couple of these features on the magic shortcuts. I can design a little banner if I like. It will just take me out of the main design interface into this section here. So let me just put a motivational quote at the top just for now. And then once I'm done here, I can edit the text, I can change the image, etc. Just like with everything else in Canva, I just hit save and it will bring me back into my Canva doc. So now I have my banner. I'm going to do a heading. So we can do heading goes here, and then we can do, subheading goes here, and then we can do body text as well. So it works a bit like a word processor. Now we can look at some of these other things here. I can embed a presentation like I showed you earlier, and I just need the link for the presentation, and that will come in here, and it's fully activated, I can click through the pages and show my presentation within the doc, which is great for collaboration. I can also, what else can we do? We can add a table. So you just define the number of columns and rows and then you have your table there. I'm just zooming through these to show you what's possible. I love a good checklist. So let's just add couple of things on here. Okay, so that's how you would do a checklist. You can also do these as bulleted lists or numbered lists as well, so you can play around with that. Then you have the option to add emojis anywhere here as well. You can add that as a bulleted list. What else do we have? Pie charts. So they're over on the left panel as well. As I showed you earlier, you can add a pie chart or any kind of chart or table. The possibilities are really endless. It all works in with data. You can add in your data and make these super accurate. You can do line charts, whatever you want to add, which is great for formal documents. I'm working in Teams. Let me see, what else do we have? The other thing you can do is set a timer. So say you're working with a team and maybe you are working on a document, you just want to do it collaboratively, you can set a timer for that, which is pretty cool. And I think we're nearing the end of the options, so you can add logos in, etc. So as you can see, it's very well integrated. And I did say before, you can easily add in, you don't even have to click here, you can just go to photos and just add in a photo. Super simple. And same goes for video. All right, so that is a bit of a walkthrough of how to use the magic shortcuts. I just want to show you a couple more quick things. You can go to canva.com/docs for more information about everything docs, but I just wanted to show you here that you can also collaborate with your Canva docs. So you basically just go to your share settings, you can give permissions for other team members to join you, and then you can collaborate in real time, which is pretty cool if you're working on a project or document together. The team members then can add comments, give replies, and it means that you can work anywhere on a document with anyone. The other thing I want to highlight is that you also get insights for your Canva doc, so you can track your engagement with insights if it's something that you're sharing with an audience, and you can turn your documents into a presentation deck. Let me show you how. Docs to Decks is pretty awesome. It's one of the new features as part of Canva Docs. You just need to have a Canva doc, which I have here. This is from one of Canva's templates. Come up here to convert and click convert to presentation. And now the magic begins. You get this little preview screen. I just click get started and Canva will take everything in that doc, the charts, the tables, the photos, and convert it into a presentation. And it's really quite intuitive. As you will see when this pops up in a moment, the options that I'm given are pretty cool. This is one that I liked before, so it's defaulted to that. But you can see there's quite a few sort of generic options there. I can also choose to have my brand applied. And if I scroll down here, it's not looking too bad. I mean, this is quite a nice layout and it's intuitively put whole page images and not a lot of text on the page. So I'm going to click create my presentation because I think that looks good and that's a really good starting point for me. So if you're not someone that's creating presentations from scratch and you're not a designer, this is a really good place to begin. And again, now I've got a lot of this is ready to go. Like I wouldn't change this layout because it's nice with a lot of white space, but maybe here I might fix up this alignment a little bit, or say this one here, the text should be a little bit bigger, so I'll make that a little bit bigger for a presentation. You need to have a bigger text, so you can play around with this, but I cannot fault the way that this has come out. Like the actual layout, from a layout perspective, it's pretty cool. So this is a game changer as far as integrating everything you're doing. If you're working on a doc and being able to turn it into a presentation really quickly, you can then embed this back into your doc if you want. There's just so many things that you can do visually with this that makes it a really great thing for all of us. Before I share the magic tool that has been added to Canva Docs, tell me, are you loving Canva Docs? Hit the like button below if you do so that more people will be shown this video. Okay, time for some magic. Meet Magic Write. It's a new AI text generator. It helps you get ideas on a page, get your first draft done, and think of it as a handy tool for copy, content ideas, lists, bios, captions, brainstorming, anything you need to write. Let's test out Magic Write. Now I have a Canva doc open. I just need to hit the plus button here to get started and I click on Magic Write and then all I need to do is put in a prompt. Now I'm going to do some simple ones. It's Christmas time when I'm recording this and I just want to do some fun prompts. So I want it to write me a Christmas themed post for my Facebook group to introduce Magic Write. I hit enter and see what comes up. And this is good. Ho, ho, ho. It's the most wonderful time of the year and here at Magic Write, we're ready to help you make the most of it, etc. It talks about how it works. You can add holiday-themed backgrounds, images and text to create a personalized message and then a little bit of a finish. So that's not bad. I've seen different variations of this. So I tried a couple of them. Some of them talked about how the AI works. So that is fun and it's good for social posts. You don't really need to do a lot of tweaking. It's sort of like a basic level kind of content. But obviously, if it's something more in-depth, then you would need to write it in your own words. But it's great for getting started. Let's do something else fun here. Let's do a fun Christmas wrap that mentions Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. See what Magic Write comes up with for this. Okay. I like that. It starts with yo. That's a good way to start a rap. I'm not going to sing this. Yo, it's Christmas time for Christmas cheer. Let's celebrate the time of year. Blah, blah, blah. Goes down. That's good. I mean, it's pulling in content from all sorts of sources, but that's not bad just to give you a good starting point. Now, let's take that up a level again. I'm going to ask it. I had some fun with this the other day because one of my friends tried this to write me a story about Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer in the style of a Shakespearean sonnet. Use lots of fun medieval language. Again, the more detail you add, the better. I'm not adding a lot in here, but look at what it's pulling out from just that little prompt. A tale of yore of Rudolph's nose of red. So bright it led a jolly Santa's sled. Laugh and jeer. Looks like there's a little bit of Shakespearean language in here. So, yeah, lots and lots of fun. One last one. Just on this fun style of content. Oops, I missed the last bit there. I did say it could write me a rom-com, so let's see what it comes up with a rom-com Christmas movie. Suggest two leading actors of any gender to play the lead roles. Add a big twist that we wouldn't expect. I'll see if it comes up with a twist. Okay, rom-com about two strangers, both in the city for the holidays, different backgrounds. The big twist is that they're running away from their own Christmas plans in order to be together. It's not a huge twist. I did try this the other day and the twist was that they were ghosts, so that was pretty good. But it comes up with different ideas every time. It didn't give me the actors' names. I did try this before and got Ryan Gosling and Sandra Bullock, I think. But as you can see, you can have a lot of fun with this for generating ideas. You start with a prompt and the magic happens. A couple of things to know about Magic Write. It's currently only available in Canva Docs at the time of this recording, but is available to free and pro users. Free users get to make up to 25 queries in a lifetime, and pro or Teams users can generate up to 75 queries per month. And it currently works best in English, but will be rolled out to other languages coming soon. And as always, you can access my extended Canva Pro trial for 45 days as a Canva verified expert. The link is in the description below. Let's try a couple of more business related type posts. So let's say I want to ask it to write me 5 Twitter posts about your upcoming launch of a new candle product featuring embedded crystals. Let's see how it goes with that. Okay, this is pretty good. Ready to add some sparkle to your home. A new candle product featuring embedded crystals is here. Add a touch of magic to your home. So this is really fun. It's even bringing in some hashtags, etc. Let's try 5 ideas for marketing your new running shoes. Okay, so it's giving you different ways of promoting the running shoes. So leveraging influencers, creating a try before you buy program, partnering with local running stores, running a contest, hosting a launch event, and utilizing social media. These are really valid ideas for marketing and a really great starting point. You can then get more granular and give it more content, more detailed content to narrow it down. But I can't really fault that. Let's try, say you were wanting to write a blog or an essay. Let's say a blog. Because you want to keep this as original content. So we're really just asking for 5 points, not the whole blog post, because you would write it in your own words. So let's see what happens here. 5 points of a blog about essential design principles. Okay, this is good. Balance, hierarchy, contrast, repetition, and proximity. And then you would take this and flesh it out into a full blog post. Okay, and let's do one more. Let's say you run a parenting blog or site, or you sell products that are relevant to parents, and maybe just want to add some humor about parenting to your content. Okay, parenting, when you love someone enough to let them drive you crazy, where coffee before talkie is a daily mantra, where you find yourself randomly counting to 3, 2, 1, oh yes, and where you learn to sleep on command, where you can turn a 3-minute task into a 30-minute adventure. These are really good. If you were stuck for a social post, this is a good place to come and just try and nut out a few ideas. Just a couple of final tips for Magic Write. Firstly, be super descriptive. The better the words you put in, the better Magic Write's output will be. Secondly, always review and refine the output to make it your own. It's always better if you add your own flair, your own words. Use Magic Write as a beginning point to get started. And thirdly, be aware of limitations. This is an evolving feature in Canva and AI in general. You can use Magic Write for commercial or personal projects, but please check the terms and conditions and understand that duplicate content is possible and that you don't have the rights to content created. So for this reason, I would personally, at least for now, use it more for light content like social media posts, blog post ideas, fun content, getting started with tweets, etc., or even just getting started with the bones of an article. But I would avoid important documents like legal documents, assignments, or essays, or anything that needs to be original. For now, Canva has not included Magic Write in education accounts, and that is for some of these reasons. That may change in future, but for now it's just evolving and it's not currently offered in education accounts, so just bear that in mind. But Magic Write will continue to evolve, and I think it's going to be, when used well, a really fun and helpful tool in your toolkit, especially when paired with Canva Docs. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial all about Canva Docs and Magic Write. Enjoy playing with these features and I'll look forward to hearing what you think. Don't forget to subscribe for more Canva videos to level up your visual storytelling. And be sure to check out the next video for more Canva tips. Stay creative.